All right, let's try to draw a picture of this conditional distribution. See if I can do that well. And we already defined the conditional distribution of y given x equal to a small value of x is given by this ratio. And let's draw a picture. This is my sample space. Let's call that omega. And suppose there is a random variable y, and it can take four possible values, let's say. Let's say in this range, y equal to 1, let me use a color, y equals to 1, and in this range, y equal to 2. And finally, in the last part, y equals to 4. So y take 4 values, and the probability of these 4 different sets give you the distribution of y. Py of y, this is defined for y equal to 1, 2, 3, or 4, or 4 cases. Now, how do we understand this conditional probability of y given x? The probably conceptually easier to think of this is, let's start by thinking of the conditional distribution of y given an event, a. Right, this is easy to think of. Suppose there is an event a that's occurred. This event, let's draw that. Use this color. Well, let's just use black. This is event A. We observe this event A occurs. So that means anything out of this event A, they don't happen. So now this defines a new distribution. This red part corresponds to y equal to 1. This blue part corresponds to y equal to 2. Y equal to 3. Y equal to 4. Yep. So now this 4 different range give me a new distribution. It's a function of y. It's the wrong color. It's the still wrong color. It's the probability of y equals to this y and the event a occurs divided by probability of event a. Now this condition on a random variable is nothing but a specialization that this a event is equal to the event x equals to small x. Right. The important thing is that the conditional distribution is still a distribution of y. For any value of x or any event a you're conditioned on, this and this, this conditional distribution they're still a valid distribution of y. That means they satisfy everything you know about a distribution. They have non-negative entries between 0 and 1, sum up to 1. And now, conditioning is a very important concept. This is directly related to inference. And in inference problem, what we often do is we can have some kind of observation. Suppose we observe this value of x. It can take a specific value, or it can take a value in a certain range. And the question is, what does that change our knowledge about another random variable y? How does that change my prediction of the value of another random variable y? So this is conditioning is a critical component in this course.